Hello students, myself Amrita Srivastava. Today we are going to discuss class 8 supplementary first chapter. The name of the chapter is How the Camel Got His Hump, and the name of your supplementary book is It So Happened. So this is our first chapter. We will discuss here summary of the chapter so that you can easily be able to attempt question related to this chapter. So let's see what is going on in the chapter, how the camel got his humped. So first of all, we will discuss who is the writer of the story. Rudyard Kipling is the writer of this story, and there are four or five main characters: the camel, the horse, the dog, the ox, and a man and a genie. So the time of the story is, in the beginning the world was new. So it was the beginning of the world. The animals were just beginning to work for men. That means they just started to serve the men. There was a camel. He lived in the middle of a dwarfing desert. He was living alone in the desert. He did not want to work. He ate sticks and thorns. He said hump when anyone spoke to him. He said hump means always one word he was saying, that is hump, H-U-M-P-H. Every time when anyone was talking to him, he was just repeating his word hump. So first time what happened? One day, it was a Monday, and the dog came to him and again he said humph. So on Monday morning, when the horse went to him, he asked the camel to come out and trot. He asked him to join them for doing work or serving the men, but the camel said humph. The horse told the man about it. The dog came to him. He asked him to work, but the camel said humph. The ox came to him, but the camel again said humph. So every animal tries to convince him for doing work, but every time he just responded humph. So after that, the man called the horse, the dog, and the ox. He told them about the camel. To compensate the camel's work, he asked them to work double time. Just because the camel was not doing anything, so the man decided he will take double work from the other animals. So after hearing this, that the animals have to do double work, the animals got very angry. So they held a panchayat to find an answer of their problem, and in the panchayat there came the jinn of all desert. Jinn means genie. Maybe you have seen in the cartoons also that genie means a person with a supernatural power. So he came to the three animals to solve their problems. So the other animals complained about the camel to the jinn. Let's see what the jinn had done. The animals told the jinn that the camel did not work. He said only hum. The jinn assured them that he would set the camel right. Maybe the jinn found the camel in the desert. He was looking at his reflection in water. Why he was looking his reflection? Because he liked his back portion very much. That time camel have back flatter as the other animals are having. So he was looking his reflection in the water. The jinn asked him to work, but the camel said humph only. So same happened with the jinn also, that he responded again only hum. But as soon as he said this, he saw something strange. He means camel So when the camel again said this, and here the second part is going to start. So in the second part, camel saw something strange. He saw his beautiful back was puffing up. It was getting puff at the back side of the camel. He was very proud of his back, just because it was very flat at that time, so he was getting very proud. But now it's turn to be very ugly, because he has got a hump on the back. The jinn told the camel that it was his own hump. He himself had brought it upon him by not working, just because he was not working anything. So as a punishment, he had got his hump. The jinn ordered him to work, but the camel said that he could not work. This time again he said that he could not work, because this time the reason that he gave was that the hump was a big hurdle in doing the work. So the jinn told the camel that the hump had a purpose. The camel had not done work for 3 days. He would always be able to work for 3 days without eating. So from that day, camel got his hump as a curse, but it is now beneficial for the camel that they can live for many days without eating. Due to their hump, they can store fat and water in their hump. So the jinn told the camel that the hump had a purpose. The camel had not done work for 3 days, so he would always be able to work for 3 days without eating. He could live on his hump. So it is a source of energy for camel. The jinn asked a camel to behave properly. That time the genie warned him to behave properly. At the last, the camel went away to join the three animals. From that day, the camel always has a hump, but he has not caught up with his 3 days. No one can caught. He had missed them at the beginning of the world. He has not yet learned to behave. But still, the camel is not behaving well. So in our next video, we will discuss our next chapter. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.